Hi everyone, I hope you watched the earlier two videos of our chapter Understanding Secularism from CIVICS, chapter number 2. I have discussed the main points, the main aspects and some of the main important questions from the text as well. I hope you understand the chapter and you noted down the main points also. Okay, so now let's start with the Ncert exercise and let's do the definitions first. Okay, now let's start. First definition is Corsican. Okay, I'm spelling it out Corsican, Corsican. It means to force someone to do something. Okay, I'm repeating, to force someone to do something. Ki bhai matlab kisi ko jabardasti se koi kaam karwaya jaye. In the context of this chapter, it refers to the force used by illegal authority like the state. Okay, so in the context of secularism, we can say that this term can be used by a state to use the powers and authorities illegally. Okay, ki bhai apni powers ka, apne authorities ka galat tarike se istemal karna kya kehlata hai? Corsican. Okay, now next is freedom to interpret. Okay, freedom to interpret. The independence that all persons shall have to understand things in their own way. Matlab, sabhi logo ko sochne aur samajhne ki azadi hai apne tarike se. Okay, every citizen of India have equal rights to think and to turn their thinking into their own level of performing actions. Okay, now in the context of this chapter, it refers to a person's liberty to develop their own understanding and meaning of the religion they practice. In this chapter, we can say that freedom to interpret is a person's liberty to develop their own understanding and meaning of their religion they practice. ठीक है कि भाई जिस भी धर्म के वो लोग हैं, जिस भी धर्म को वो मानते हैं, उसके कल्चर, उसके ट्रेडिशन, उसके बिलीव्स को अपनाने के लिए, सोचने के लिए और समझने के लिए उनके पास पूरी आजादी है. ओके, नाउ थर्ड, इंटरवेनी. Okay, intervene. In the context of this chapter, it refers to the state's efforts to influence a particular matter in accordance with the principle of the constitution. Okay, intervene means in the context of this chapter, it refers to the state's effort to influence a particular matter in accordance with the principle of the constitution. कि भाई मतलब राज्य में कुछ अफेयर्स चल रहे हैं, कुछ कार्य चल रहा है और वो सही नहीं है, तो उसमें कौन दखल देगा? फिर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के सिद्धांत आएंगे, वो उसको बताएंगे कि एक राज्य को बताएंगे कि ये काम ऐसे नहीं, ऐसे करना है. ओके, आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? लाइक इफ यू टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ आवर क्लास, सपोज ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स वांट टू वर्क ऑन समथिंग एक्टिविटी एंड दे वांट टू परफॉर्म समथिंग, but they are not getting ideas and they are confused. So who will help them? The teacher will help them, the teacher will guide them, and the teacher will motivate them to do the activity with the potential they have. In the same manner also, the constitution, the principle of the constitution shows the way or the guidelines to act as a head nation or to act as a godfather for the state to perform the particular activity in their state. Okay, so these are the three main definitions of the chapter. You can note it down. Now this is your first question. Now we will start the question answer of this chapter. Okay, I'm repeating the question. List the different types of religious practice that
you find in your neighborhood. This could be different form of prayer, worship of different gods, sacred sites, different kinds of religious music and singing, etc. Does this indicate freedom of religious practice? Suppose आपके आसपास मंदिर भी है, मस्जिद भी है, चर्च भी है, गुरुद्वारा भी है, एंड मंदिर में सुबह और शाम के वक्त आरती होती है, गुरुद्वारे में दिन भर वाणी चलती रहती है, चर्च में बेल रिंग करती हैं, ओके, एंड मस्जिद में सुबह और शाम के वक्त नमाज सुनाई देती है, तो इन सब चीज़ों को देख के क्या आपको ये लगता है कि हमारे देश में धर्म को आज़ादी मिली हुई है? Now let's discuss the list of different types of religious practice forms in my neighborhood are Hindus performing puja or we can say worship and invest and visiting temples, Jain visiting the Jain temples, Buddha visiting the Gautam Buddha temples, Sikh are visiting Gurudwaras and do path, Muslim offering namaz, Christians offer prayer in church. So these kinds of activities we see in our neighborhood, and this indicates freedom of religious practice given by the constitution to every citizen of India. Like we can say, according to the constitution of India, every citizen of our country, no matter whether he is a Christian, he is a Muslim, he is a Sikh, he is a Jain, he is a Bodh, he is a Hindu, whatever he follow the religion, he is free to practice his own religion and follow the culture, tradition and beliefs of his religion. Okay, so the freedom of religion is there as a fundamental right also. Now let's shift to question number 2. Will the government intervene if some religious group says that their religion allows them to practice infanticides? Give reason for your answer. क्या आपको लगता है कि कभी किसी धर्म के साथ कुछ गलत हो रहा है तो उसमें सरकार अपना हस्तक्षेप करती है? कैसे? आइए जानते हैं और रीजन भी देना है. ओके, यस, द गवर्नमेंट विल इंटरव्यू इफ सम रिलीजियस ग्रुप सेज दैट देयर रिलीजन अलाउज देम टू प्रैक्टिस इन्फेंटिसाइड्स बिकॉज आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन नेवर अलाउज एनी रिलीजन टू प्रैक्टिस सच कस्टम. यस, सपोज इन्फेंटिसाइड, डू यू नो व्हाट इज इन्फेंटिसाइड? इन्फेंटिसाइड इज टू लाइक टू किल द बेबी इन द वॉर्म ऑफ द मदर. Okay, like to kill the baby in the womb of the mother is a heinous crime. According to the constitution of India, no religion will do this kind of activity, and if anyone practice this kind of activity, the doctor and the people who are committing this kind of crime will be punished by the constitution, and the government will definitely interfere in this matter. Okay, or they will look into it very seriously. Okay, now question number four says up, look up the annual calendar of holidays of your school. How many of them pertain to different religions? What does this indicate? आप अपने स्कूल के हॉलीडे कैलेंडर को देखते हैं और उसमें गवर्नमेंट हॉलीडेज भी होती हैं, तो क्या आप उन छुट्टियों को देख के क्या अंदेशा लगा सकते हैं, क्या समझ सकते हैं फॉर व्हाट दे हैव बीन डिजाइंड? ओके, आफ्टर लुकिंग एट द कैलेंडर ऑफ आवर स्कूल वी फाइंड दैट इट कंटेन्स हॉलीडेज फॉर ऑल रिलीजन्स. ओके, मतलब हम अपने स्कूल के छुट्टी का कैलेंडर देख के ये कह सकते हैं कि इसमें सभी धर्मों के लिए इक्वल छुट्टीज हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, holidays on Diwali, Holi, Dashera, Raksha Bandhan for Hindus, Shivratri, Mahashivratri also, and for Muslim community we celebrate Eid, Ramzan, okay, and for Sikh we do holidays on Baisakhi, Lohdi, Guru Nanak Jayanti, okay, and for Christians we have holiday of Good Friday. Okay, so this indicates that
to our school believes in secularism. Okay, so and this also tells that our school also follow secularism, the policy of secularism, and also they celebrate all the festivals with great excitement. And as we all know that in our school also we do celebrate Diwali celebration, Holi celebration, Raksha Bandhan, okay, Dashara and all other type of religious festival as well. Find out some examples of different, find out some examples of different views within the same religions. Okay, now we have to find out some example of these, some common things between the different religions. Okay, some examples of different views within the same religions are, Hindus are divided into Shiva and Vaishnav. Okay, like some of the Hindus do the worship of Lord Shiva and some of the Hindus do the worship of Lord Vishnu. Okay, now Muslims are divided into Shias and Sunnis. Okay, like Muslims are divided into Shias and Sunnis. Buddhists are divided into Mahayan and Hinayan. Okay, Buddhists are divided into Mahayan and Hinayan. Followers of Lord Mahavira are called Jains. Who follow the policy, the teachings of Mahavira, they are called Jains, and they are divided into two groups, that is Shvetambar and Digambar. Okay, and these are Shvetambars and Digambars. So we can conclude that every religion is divided into at least two different communities. Okay, and they follow the same culture and tradition, but the communities did not follow, they follow the rules and teachings of a proper channel that they are in. Okay, now last question of this chapter, the Indian state both keeps away from religions well as interveners in religion. The idea can be quite confusing. Discuss this once again in class using examples from the chapter as well as those that you might have come up with. Okay, now this Indian state both keeps away from religions as well as intervene in religion. This means that every citizen in India is to free their religion and perform rituals, but if any ritual is against the ruler's rules and regulations, then Indian state may intervene. Okay, so the question is saying that the Indian constitution has provided equal status, standard, class to the every religion and every community people who are living in India, and they are free to follow their religion, they are free to do their worship, they are free to do follow their culture, custom, traditions, belief of their particular religion. But if in case they are doing some kind of illegal activities on the name of their religion which are against the rules and regulations of our country, then the state will definitely interfere in them and take a serious inquiry from the evil practices done by the people on the name of religion, and can also punish them according to the act passed by the Constitution of India. So this was all about your chapter understanding the secularism. Now the chapter has been complete and I am giving a 10 second pause on every question so that you can pause the video and note it down in your notebook. Thank you. I hope the chapter is very much clear to you and I hope you will complete the question answers. Okay. Students, you all have to note down your question and answer in a good hand. Okay, the writing should be neat and clear. Thank you. And now your chapter is complete. Do complete your question answers.